Okay, so those were just the appetizers. This next move is the main course of the knee on belly escapes. This is the one that's the real showstopper that actually is a legit reversal from bottom, which is a great thing because it's very hard to reverse people from bottom side control. Relatively difficult to reverse them from bottom mount. But there's a move from knee on belly, which is a total get out of jail free card almost any time that you attempt it. So let's do it from this side for me because this is my good side for this one. So we're still doing the same thing here, where I'm supporting at the knee. I always want to do that because for the same reasons I mentioned earlier, where if we're extending up, this is where the arm locks happen and we're in danger. So from here, this time, I'm going to bring both my knees to the inside area of his leg. So my right leg right now is on the outside. I want to turn so that my right knee comes in like this. And the way I do that is by going from my one hand on the knee to push at his far knee like this. When I turn and reach like this, this starts to help as an anchor point, but also just to kind of like, you can actually take out his base a little bit by pushing on that knee because he's so focused on driving in like this. He's not as concerned about that leg. And this leg's very light because all the weight's on me. So this is, he's super sturdy here. This is difficult, can't move much. But if I just reach across, I can kind of just bop that knee and that's gonna allow me to start turning in like this. And I bring my knee up in between us. Does everyone see that? So now, his knee pressure is off my solar plexus, and I'm actually supporting his weight on my hip bones themselves. So my hip is now vertical instead of where it was flat. I'm just supporting him on top of my hips. Doesn't take any active muscle engagement or anything. I've just created a frame with my lower body here. At this point, I reach and I go around my leg. So let's move this arm just so they can see this here. I reach around my leg like this. And this further is just gonna create one solid block on the right side of my body. I'm just like locking the whole right side of myself here. And now the key here is my left foot plants, toes down, and I'm gonna use that plant to lift my hips and turn. And now it's not always gonna turn out exactly how it happens right here. You're gonna have to experiment a little bit with how this ends up. But essentially what I can do is because he doesn't have very much base to that side, I'm gonna lift and I'm gonna hook his knee here to bring him up and over like this. So it's very rare that they just tilt like that. So Sloan, what I'm gonna have you do is like, give me a little bit of resistance. So he's like still chasing into me, like pushing into me. And when I grip like this, I'm not necessarily, if Sloan keeps his balance, won't necessarily be able to lift him over. But what happens is I do that same thing where this time, instead of going underneath, I do go up to my elbow like this so that I can tuck my elbow up and then underneath. Because if I could, I would bring it right through here, but I can't in this scenario because I'm not gonna be able to get my hips off the mat with the same movement we did in the previous move because his weight is on my hips. So I have to do the opposite version where I go here and I go forward and then that tucks my elbow in. And from this point, if Sloan continues to push into me here, I can get all the way up to my knees and then kind of roll through like this. See how we end up in this awkward scenario where his leg is trapped? Let's see if we can rotate this way a little bit. So because his leg is trapped here, he's got no base to that side, and I can just start sitting up like this. And then I'm just doing technical stand-up and ending up on top, okay? Let's do it from this angle. Do it on this side for me. Maybe I can do it a little better this side. So again, the hand here that was on the knee is reaching across, and from this position, I'm hugging my own knee up on my elbow and turning in and through here. And so the reason this works is because I've kind of hooked both his legs with my one leg, so he's not able to escape. And he can't do a technical stand-up because this leg is trapped between my legs as well. And if he turns away, it's the only real option for him to turn away. That's just giving me the opportunity to come up. So this one's kind of funky, but it's very, very effective. I'm gonna do it a few times just without this. Just to kind of demonstrate a little more. So I'm here. You don't necessarily have to reach with this, with the left hand. You can reach with this hand as well and hug here. And if he brings the knee across more, like this, it works even better. Because from here, I can really just start turning like this. And this can transition into like X guard positions as well, hooking this leg and extending away. Think of it like, if any of you have ever wrestled, it's kind of like a funk roll, where you're like rolling underneath the person. But the key is this movement here, where I go up onto my shoulder and either roll directly through, or I'm able to just lift and just hit a straight across turn. Okay, any questions on that? Let's give it a shot. 1, 2, 3. Exactly. And the left arm is still pushing at this for now, and then it's going up to get up to your shoulder and your elbow. Yep. Yes, roll through. Perfect. See how it just gets her off of you? And then you just let go of your own knee. And then you just keep facing this way. Yeah, technically stand up. Yep, that's all it is. It's coming up. Keep just, yeah, spin through. Yes. Exactly.
So from here, should I do it?
You just let go of your own leg and you can do technical stand up. Yeah. So for this one, keep your knee on belly. Try and give him a little bit more like horizontal knee on belly here. So this one's going to reach across. This knee's going to go underneath. And you're going to hook around the top of your own knee like this. Start to turn up and in. But not all the way. You want to stay on your hip. You just want to get up enough so that now you can kind of tuck your body underneath his body and roll through. Yes, exactly. And then just let go of your own knee and come up on top. The left knee, Austin, hooks in, and you're reaching over the top of your own knee with your left arm. So that's this arm reaches over the top. Yeah, this one actually goes to this knee.
Oh, here. Like
yeah,
this.
Yeah. This one comes out and is pushing at his knee to create space. Okay. And then you can either go up to your shoulder to tuck under, or if you can, you can just bring this leg up and plant it and just turn right left. But if you, yeah, you can just go straight left. But a lot of times their balance will be too good. So go back. And in that case, you kind of have to get up onto your shoulder and head and then kind of roll through like a forward roll. Exactly. But don't leave your knee on the outside. It has to hook. Yeah, you got to keep that hook. And then from here, he can't do a technical stand-up because his leg is isolated. You just have to let go of your knee. See, yep, and just come up. Yeah. Here, try it on me if it feels like this. Do it on me. So I'll be here. I'm hooking. Like this. And then there's two ways you can do it. You can like walk your toes to like get this leg through and start turning this way, which sometimes doesn't work if they hit a nice cross face. Like if you're really cross facing me, it can be hard to do that one. And in that case, I have to go here, up, and then through.
So sick.
Yeah. This is one of those moves that it works better live when both people are fighting. It's kind of a difficult move to drill because it's very awkward and people try and help their partner, which actually hurts the position. But when the gears are both moving at the same speed, it looks a lot smoother.